A new study shows that iPhone, Netflix, and Instagram are dominating your kids' time online. Research firm Piper Jeffrey just released a survey in which they polled over 8,000 teenagers around the age of 16 about their purchasing preferences and habits and how they planned to make purchases in the future. This study found that iPhone is the most popular smartphone among teenagers. Netflix is where they prefer to get their streaming video, and Instagram is now the ruler of teenage social media. iPhone was found to have 82% of the market share. 86% of teenagers said that they were interested in buying an iPhone as their next smartphone. Only 10% of those surveyed said they were interested in possibly buying an Android phone. Netflix has passed YouTube now, with 38% of the market share compared to YouTube's 33%. So some of the new content on Netflix, and maybe surprisingly, some of the older shows that are now being streamed on Netflix, has driven teenagers to use it as their main streaming platform. Instagram is now used even more than Snapchat, possibly because of some of the copied features that Instagram is using that drew teenagers to Snapchat in the first place. Also, possibly due to Snapchat's willingness to make big changes to their app in order to attract more marketers. Whatever the reason, my advice is to use this information to help you make good decisions about raising your kids. You know, this info is meant to help marketers appeal to teenagers and reach them with their message of buy our product. But we as parents can use this information to help inform our decisions on setting boundaries for what our kids do online. It could be very helpful to know that your kids prefer watching things on Netflix than they do on YouTube. Now, they're probably spending time on both platforms, but we're seeing that Netflix is passing up the others. It's also important to understand that the majority of what your kids are doing on social media is now done on Instagram. All the things that you can do on Snapchat, you can do on Instagram, like sending disappearing messages, having private conversations and private video chats with your friends. This is stuff we need to know as parents, and the fact that it's causing them to migrate and use Instagram more is good information for us to have. One little tidbit that was in this study that I think is important for us to note is that many kids are now buying their video games through online download. This means that there are no restrictions unless you set them digitally. So there's no longer some guy at the store checking your kid's ID to make sure they're old enough to buy that rated M game. Xbox, PlayStation, Steam for computer games, they all have ways for you to set parental controls so that certain games can't be purchased without permission. Or you just control it by not allowing them to use your credit card at will online. However you do it, keep track of what your kids are doing on social media, on streaming video, what kind of devices they want to purchase. iPhone is my favorite device, so that being the major market share makes it easier for parents because I believe their parental controls are easier to set. Use this information. Let it be a tool in your toolkit to help you raise your kids with the right kind of boundaries, allowing them to explore within those boundaries, make good choices about their screen time and who they contact and what they do online. Thank you for watching. I'm Michael Prince with becausefamily.org and familytechblog.com.
Hi, I'd like to thank you for watching our videos. I just wanted to let you know that Because Family is a nonprofit organization. All money donated to Because Family goes to help us make videos like this, articles like the one this video is attached to, do seminars and free workshops for families to teach them how to keep their kids safe online, to teach digital citizenship to kids, to write curriculum, and all kinds of wonderful stuff that we try to do to help families be internet smart and safe. So if you'd like to donate, you can go to becausefamily.org/partnership and give to help us keep doing that. Thanks a lot.